tomorrow is the designated feast day, being Friday after the second Sunday after Pentecost. We're offering this Vigil Mass for the good estate of Margaret Caulfield. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were lifted up to draw the people to yourself. Lord, have mercy. You shouldered the cross to bear our suffering and sinfulness. Christ, have mercy. You opened for your people the way from death into life. Lord, have mercy. Your mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, the Lord Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in the heart of your Son, wounded by our sins, bestowed us in mercy the boundless treasures of your love, grant, we pray, that in paying homage to him the homage of our devotion, we may also offer worthy reparation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen.
Lord, is ever lasting upon redeems your life from the grave, who crowns you with love and compassion. The love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear. The Lord does deeds of justice, gives judgment for all who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, and his deeds to Israel's sons. The love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear. The Lord is compassion and love, slow to anger and rich in mercy. He does not treat us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our faults. The love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear.
Jesus exclaimed, "I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever, and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal them. Come to me, all you who labour and overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Rationally, we would say that the mind is the core of our being. But spiritually, many would agree that the heart is the centre of a person, where our sentiments and our intentions dwell. Indeed, in the heart of the Redeemer lies God's love for humanity and his will for our salvation. To adore the sacred heart of Jesus is to recognise God's love for the world, and that from Jesus' heart flows the wellspring of the Church's sacramental life. At his conception and birth, God weds the divine to the human, but it is on the cross where this marriage is consummated. It is in Jesus' sacred heart where we see the two realities joining, as the vertical strand across heaven meets the horizontal human, and from this point the sacramental life of the Church is born. The whole month of June is dedicated to the Sacred Heart of Jesus as an antidote for sin, whether that be personal or societal, and especially those temptations that deal with our base passions. It is also a month given to us to stay within the truth of Christ, wisdom personified, so that we may avoid the philosophies of the so-called learned and the clever, which are often so heretical. The Sacred Heart of Jesus is an infinite expression of mercy, always open to the sinner who wishes to repent of their behaviour and grow in holiness. For it is on the cross that Jesus poured out his blood for the forgiveness of our sins and transformed his suffering and death into a sacrificial offering that brings about our salvation. Although this devotion grows in prominence in the 17th century due to the revelation to St. Margaret Mary Alacoque, it can of course be traced back through the writings and teachings of the Fathers of the Church, Ambrose, Jerome, Augustine, etc. But St. Margaret Mary receives a fresh understanding, assurances of peace, comfort, and holiness to those who honour our Lord's Sacred Heart. It is also a promise that we will receive all the graces necessary for our state of life. Jesus became what we are to make us what he is, assimilating to himself our human nature, to perfect it and raise it up so it may share in his glory. Indeed, this feast assures us of God's constant love for his sheep. Jesus, as the Good Shepherd, is the visible manifestation of God's love for the world. Jesus wants us to share his own knowledge of the Father, that God is love, and it seems so appropriate that the image of the Sacred Heart shows the heart on the outside, affixed to the body of Christ, itself an image of the Church. And while the image of the Sacred Heart is itself an image of the crucifixion, it is not an image of torture, but an image of divine love. That God so loved the world that he sent his only Son to be our Saviour and Redeemer. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the supreme revelation of the Father's love for the world, a love that is authentic because it is life-giving, it's never selfish, it's never self-serving. It is a love that cares for the sheep, inviting those who are burdened by life's cares to come to him and find rest. It is also a sign of a future reality, that in heaven the faithful departed find heaven to be a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our Saviour was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess from baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, gathered as one to celebrate the good things we have received from God, let us ask him to prompt in us prayers that are worthy of his hearing. For Francis of our home, especially as he recovers from surgery, and Richard, our bishop, and all the clergy, with the people entrusted to their charge. Lord, in your mercy, for those who hold public office, and those who assist them in promoting the common good, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all those who have bound themselves to God, that with his help they may faithfully keep to their resolve, Lord, in your mercy, for all of us gathered in this sacred place by faith and devotion and by love and reverence for God, Lord, in your mercy, for the elderly who suffer from isolation or sickness, that they may be strengthened by our love of them as brothers and sisters, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And for the faithful departed, those who die this day, and for those with anniversaries at this time, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. May the petitions of your church be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, so that what we may receive from your mercy, what we cannot ask out of confidence in our own merits, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look, O Lord, we pray on the surpassing charity in the heart of your beloved Son, that what we may offer may be an acceptable gift to you, and the expiation of our offences through Christ our Lord.
Amen. O Lord,
we be with you.
Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love, poured out blood and water from his blessed side, the wellspring of the church's sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Saviour, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim,
Holy, Holy, Holy,
which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Richard our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered whose faith and devotion are known to you, for then we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying the homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God, our Lord Jesus Christ, our blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Titus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damien, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting power. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased that God, we pray, to bless the knowledge and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. And therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven, of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as one should be pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your little angel to your altar and bride, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, all who sleep in Christ, the place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not wearing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, for whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
For all
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May this sacrament of charity, O Lord, make us fervent with the fire of holy love, so that drawn always to your Son, we may learn to see him in our neighbour, through Christ our Lord. So once again, we should bring the solemnity of the most sacred heart tomorrow, Friday, because Friday ranks as a solemnity. Friday abstinence is not required.